The app Arboreal Forest has a lot of features. I will now show you some of the more advanced ones, and if you haven't looked at the first tutorial, I recommend to look at that first before this one. When you start measuring, you could always access the settings in the lower left corner of the screen. You have two different presets, default or plantation, and as it sounds, plantation is when you are measuring in a plantation, when the trees are in a row and you want to add many stems on the tree and call it codes and so on. I strongly recommend that you use the default. You could choose between imperial or the metric system, and you could choose to have this auto tree species that that app will detect what tree species it is, and it only works in the Nordic countries. Auto diameter measurement, it's available if you have a phone with LiDAR, then the app will detect the tree automatically and you don't need to press the button to measure the tree diameter. Speak the species, then the app will speak the tree species after you have done the diameter measurements, and it helps you avoiding assigning the wrong tree species. Record age and growth, it's let you add age and growth to the height tree after you have measured it. When you have chosen the plot size, you can see a blue arrow that points at north. Sometimes it's really important that it's correct. For example, if you want to match the positions of the trees with aerial data or some other data. And if you see that the arrow is pointing in the wrong direction, like you have a bad compass in the phone, then you could tap on the blue arrow and point at the true north, and then the local coordinate system will realign to the north. When you have placed out the center of the plot, it's time to measure the diameters. And if you take a look at the upper part of the screen, you see an arrow to the left. And if you press that, you go back to the previous step. But when you start measuring diameters, a trash can will emerge there, and if you press that, you will delete the last tree diameter measurement. You could select the species in the lower part of the screen. We press the species, a new menu will appear, and you will see could select by different species. If you want to change the species of the last tree you have measured, you could just tap on the last decal, and it will change the species. You could also swipe on the decal, and that will mark the tree as damaged or undamaged. If you long tap on the last decal, a menu will appear and you could add a comment to the tree. You could change the diameter manually or assign it as damaged or undamaged or change the tree species. After you have measured the diameter, you could move and measure the same tree again. Then you will get the average diameter of these two measurements. When you have measured all the diameters of the trees in the plot, you could go forward to the next step by pressing the arrow button in the upper part of the screen. Press the measure button on the tree species that you want to measure the height on. And if you're close to a tree and you have a phone with LiDAR, the tree will also measure the diameter of the tree. Then you walk away from the tree and mark the base and the top of the tree. If it's hard to see the base of the tree and the top of the tree from the same position, you could mark them from different positions. When you have measured the height, you could also add a comment to this tree you have measured on. You could measure many trees of each tree species. And if you press the height value, you will see all the measured tree heights for that species. And then there you could also add heights manually, or delete measured heights. When you have measured all the heights you need, you go forward and then you will see the summary of the plot. I hope that you have learned something new and will find the app useful. Good luck with your measurements.